The last episode on Christmas tablescapes was so much fun. We decorated a table for a very low cost, but it turned out to be very sophisticated. As promised, I'm back to show you two more tablescape themes that I did with my friends Patricia, Chummy, and Andy. This is Teach with Joy, and I am Joy Mendoza. Like I mentioned previously, when you plan for a tablescape, don't forget to research online, pick your color palette, and start gathering your table elements. You can borrow, recycle, or reuse to save on cost. For this episode, I'm going to show you how to do tropical and rustic landscapes. So here we have a tropical theme. So ano ba yung tropical na theme? Yung pinili namin na tropical theme because sometimes you can do like parang neutral na theme, na tropical, pero for this one, we made it more colorful. So as you can see, ang daming elements na may color here, parang yun yung feel niya talaga like you're in maybe Hawaii or maybe at a beach somewhere and you feel like you're on a vacation. If you cannot travel right now, diba? Just make your tablescape like a tropical theme and you feel like you're in a certain kind of paradise. So what are the elements that are on this table to make it like a tropical theme? So besides the colorful flowers, you can see we also use mga fruit. Oh, so may dual purpose to. Pwede siyang mag-add ng color sa table, pero pwede din kainin ng mga guests ninyo. Pag hindi nila kinain, you save it for the next day, you can eat it. Para walang sayang. And then, one of my friends, pinintura niya ang coconut shell na to in a cream color, so it made a nice accent as a vase. And these flowers, pag pupunta kayo sa Dangwa, tapos bibili kayo ng mga green leaves, murang-mura lang siya. Like isang bundle, 10 pesos, 20 pesos, 30 pesos. So, napaka-versatile yung mga green na leaves because you can use it not just in a tropical theme but in other themes as well. And it adds volume to the tablescape para hindi, pag konti lang yung mga flowers niyo kasi ayaw niyo mag-spend too much on flowers. Pag nag-add kayo ng greens, magiging may volume yung mga centerpieces ninyo, yung mga decor. And then, itong goblets na to, binili ko na to eh noon pa. So, I just invested in this and we can use it for multiple themes. And it came also with a corresponding taller glass. And it just adds a little more drama to the table. So, itong cups na to, or you know, sauce bowls, matagal na rin to. Nabili ko to sa Baguio. I think it was like 3 for 100. Murang-mura lang siya. But very versatile. You can also use it with a rustic theme. Pero perfect siya for this tropical theme. It feels very earthy and grounded. And then, itong mga vase na to, nasa bahay ko na to eh, long time ago. So, I just put it together with my friends for this tropical theme. Pinansin niyo yung ribbon nito. Actually, yung isang kaibigan ko, she just had ribbon laying around in her house. So we went through all her ribbons, si Patricia. And then we said, oh, we can use that. We can use this. So these are just not even purchased. It was just stuff that she had in her house. And look at how this is done. A simple lang. You just basically fold a white napkin and then you add elements and details para may konti siyang, you know, extra, right? So when people sit down, it's like, oh wow, that's so thoughtful. You even folded my napkin, you decorated it for me. So as your guests come in, they will appreciate, you know, the key is hindi pwedeng pantay-pantay lahat yung height. Kasi pag pantay-pantay lahat ng height, wala siyang parang layers. It's not as nice to look at. So that's why there's some that are a little higher, some taller here, and you can't have all tall because hindi kayo pwedeng mag-usap sa table, di ba? Pag lahat mataas. And you can see here, we even used a pineapple. And then later, tomorrow, kakainin ko to. So yun, simple lang. Tapos yung mga risers na to, that's from my friend. She had it in her house, and we just brought it here for this tablescape. Instead of using a placemat, I got bigger leaves. These were also super cheap. I think 30 pesos for like 8 pieces. And we used that instead as a tablecloth. O, diba? So actually super simple. Pero yung effect niya when it's all put together, it's nice. It's got pops of color and it feels very, it feels like you're maybe in a jungle, like I said, or maybe at the beach or somewhere not that's not your home, somewhere away. And just something a little fun for your guests when they come over. Next up, the rustic theme. Rustic can be styled into a more simple, homey, casual, rugged, or natural look. Now here we have a rustic theme. So kung napansin ninyo, yung table na to, actually super luma siya, ha? And may mga bugbog, pero pag rustic kasi, okay lang na ganyan ang itsura niya. Hindi siya pwede sa formal, hindi siya bagay. But when you're doing like a rustic theme, it's okay. And the thing about a rustic theme, marami siyang textures. It's a very earthy palette. Very warm yung tones niya. And a lot of stuff it doesn't have to look perfect kasi rustic nga. This one, for example, is the squash na pininturahan ni Patricia. She worked very hard on that kaninang umaga. And imagine you just buy a squash sa grocery or sa market and then you paint it, pero ang ganda ng effect niya. Bagay na bagay sa rustic na theme. These balls, this one was from my friend's house. Because what we do talaga, we put together all the things that we have in our house na bagay sa theme. We send out we communicate on Viber. O, ito yung theme. What can you add from your house that we can use? So ganyan lang, parang we just share each other's household decorations. And the flowers naman, as you can see, it's more the dried leaves and dried flowers. Because it's actually something you can keep using even after you're done with your event or your activity. You can use it as decor in your house. Even these succulents na binili ko sa Dangwa, parang like 3 for $100 lang siya. And after we have this dinner, we can still use it for decor in the house. Now, the goblets for the water or for the juice, we just recycled it from the other theme kanina, if you notice, pero we just put one, not yung dalawa. And so these goblets, super versatile siya. Tapos actually they come in many different colors. And so that's why I invested na lang. So in case I have parties like this, we can use it, reuse it for different themes. And then this napkin was actually something I had made before pa. In Kamuning. So, hinanap ko yung kulay na to talaga kasi this is one of my favorite colors and mahirap siya hanapin sa department store. So, I went to Kamuning, I bought the fabric, tapos pinatahi ko dun in the size of a standard napkin and they were able to do it for very reasonable. And this napkin holder, this is from Patricia's house. This one I just made on my own using some old gold beads that I had in my house and some elastic nylon. So you can see how you can put elements together for a rustic theme na may layers, organic yung feel niya. And then the cutlery na gold, ganda no? This one from Dapitan din to, and mura lang siya. I got two sets for all the parties moving forward or dinners or events. And we keep using it for different themes because it's bagay with almost every theme. This one, somebody actually made this for me before online and she sent it to me and it's so precious to me. She worked so hard on that, but it's so perfect for the rustic theme because it adds so much texture. So once again, the vases, different heights, different layers, dried stuff. This is dried eucalyptus. Mura lang siya sa Dangwa and I can reuse that for my home afterwards. Candles from Patricia's house. So it's really a collaborative effort working together. The runner, you see, was also from Patricia. and we brought it here for this today. So there, that's your rustic theme, an intimate dinner for maybe 6 people that you can host, and parang may social distancing pa yang, we spread it out para mas safe.
I hope you guys really enjoyed that experience watching us do the tablescaping, and I hope you realize that first, it doesn't have to be expensive, and you can do it with friends or family members to make it a more bonding and enjoyable experience. And you can just borrow things from one another and recycle things in order to create different themes so that you don't have to keep buying things to add to your tablescape. And then, of course, I want to thank my amazing friends, this super team that was with me today, Patricia, Chummy, Mitch, and Andy, because we put all our hearts and minds together for you in order to create these tablescapes. Please don't forget to follow us on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram, and YouTube at My Plus Network. And thank you, everyone, for being with us today and joining us for Teach with Joy Season 2.